Good morning, screen printers. Today, we're gonna do stuff a little bit different. We're gonna experiment and we're gonna print with coffee. All right, guys, so we've prepared two different types of, two methods of trying to make this ink or dye. One is gonna be with vinegar as a fixation, mixed up with some spent coffee grinds that we had over a rolling boil for a few minutes, and we brought it down to a simmer for about 30 minutes on the stove. Full disclaimer, it's definitely gonna make your kitchen or wherever you're doing it smell like burnt coffee and vinegar, so be prepared for that. The second type that we try to make is with just some instant coffee grounds that you can find off the shelf, mixed with water. Again, got it to a boil, brought it down to a simmer for about 30 minutes to thicken it up, and that's where we're at now. Now that we got the beans juiced and reduced, we're ready to move to the next step. For each of these different ones that we did, we're gonna try two different things. For each, we're going to mix it into some clear core base to see if that is a more printable way to go about this. And then we have another thing we wanna try with each of these, which is adding some silica aerosil powder to thicken it up. So let's see how both of those go. We're gonna use for the Green Galaxy clear core about a 70-30 ratio. So 70% of the clear core base and 30% of this coffee. For the aerosil, this is gonna be completely experimental. So we're gonna kind of do it as needed, add as much to it until we feel like it's a consistency that's gonna be really easy to print. And for this application, we've decided to try a 305 thin thread mesh, since this is gonna be more of a consistency similar to water-based printing. Oh God, dude. I mean, it looks like it was printed with coffee. But there's clearly some potential. Let me save your guys' time. Don't do exactly what I did, because the amount that I mixed in of that silica mix in with the actual grinds themselves was a little bit too much, to the point where I actually can't get it through this 305 thin thread. So we're probably not gonna proceed with this. As you can see, it is almost non-existent because we're not getting a deposit through the screen. Next up, we've got the instant coffee mix with the clear core base we're gonna try out. I'm feeling pretty hopeful just by the way that this looks. Got a pretty decent consistency, pretty good color. Let's see what happens. All right, that's more like it. So this is going to be the actual coffee grinds with the clear core base. And initially, I think that I added a little bit too much of the coffee grinds just because of the consistency, but I kind of had to. In order to have like the color that we need. So let's just see what happens. So looking at these prints, they actually held up pretty good detail. And when you think about it, we basically just did a controlled coffee stain on a t-shirt. That's what it is. And I gotta say, I'm actually really only pleased with one of them, the instant coffee and the thickening agent that we use. So not the clear core, but the actual silica base.
Really good coverage, great color, pretty easy to print, soft hand, and I think it's something that would really stick out in a coffee shop, so pretty cool.
All right, next up, we have the instant coffee with the clear core base. This is the runner up, in my opinion. Really good coverage. It actually got a good ink deposit. Pretty good color. It's a bit lighter than the instant coffee with the silica thickening agent, but overall, I think that this would stand out and people might like to wear it. Overall, what I'm coming to find out is that we got a lot better results with the instant coffee, which is cool because honestly, it was a lot easier to make. When you're looking at the process, seeing what we had to do to actually make those coffee grinds and reduce them with vinegar, one, it didn't smell great, and two, it seemed like it took a lot more effort. So after our initial wash tests, the instant coffee still seems to be the winner. A lot more color has washed out of each of these t-shirts than I had anticipated. I'm gonna do some research to see what other fixatives are out there other than the vinegar, to see if I can get something that'll last a little bit longer.
If you enjoyed this video, let us know in the comments, hit like, subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for joining.